Honorable Chief Minister Odisha, honorable ministers, dignitaries on the dais, captains of industry, senior officials of the state government, friends, ladies and gentlemen. It's my privilege to give you a small brief on the advantages that Odisha offers to potential investors. You've seen a short movie which talks about the attributes of the state in terms of its various advantages. Now, just building on that, let me just offer you 10 slides on the 10 advantages that Odisha has, which would make it a very compelling value proposition for any investor. In fact, just before the meeting, Mr. Tyagarajan was mentioning about the fact that Odisha is not so well known outside the state. So that's a challenge that we are now trying to meet head on. There are advantages, there are opportunities which Odisha offers, but unfortunately, we have been unable to reach out to the extent that we should have. So probably this is just one more step in that direction to ensure that the advantages and the opportunities that Odisha has is made known to the potential investors. So the first advantage is the obvious one. The state offers a very stable environment for business because of the governance. The longest serving chief minister at present with 18 plus years, and the vision that he has for the state for investment and industry is, I think, mentions a quote: "We want to become the investment destination of choice by continuously creating and delivering outstanding opportunities for business growth, fostering all-round socio-economic development for the state and its people." And this particular vision is manifested in the bottom half of the slide, where you see the tremendous growth that the state has made in the past 18 years in terms of the growth in the metal production. While Odisha was known primarily as a mineral producing state, that has changed in the past two decades, and Odisha is the top producer of metals like aluminium, steel and stainless steel. The infrastructure in terms of the port capacity, power generation and the road network have also gone, have also seen an exponential jump. So backed by all these factors, we see that there has been a great spike in the total investments that the state government has received over the past few years, and also has created a huge investment employment potential for the youth of the state. Odisha, of course, has been growing at a rate faster than the national average, and as was mentioned by the Chief Secretary, a leading industry association ranked Odisha as the number one state in terms of investment implementation. The second advantage is that we know where we have to go, so we have a plan in place. So the Vision 2025 mentions about where the state would be by the year 2025, what are the sectors that we will focus, what are the policies which are required to realize those objectives, the infrastructure which will be taken up, the skilling requirements. So it's a comprehensive plan which the Honorable CM unveiled in 2015 and is right now under implementation. So the six focus sectors which were already mentioned in the movie, the food processing including seafood, chemicals, plastics and petrochemicals, textiles and apparel, ancillary and downstream in the metal sector, electronics and IT, and tourism. The advantage number three is the mesh of ports, roads and rail network which are connecting Odisha to the hinterland and to the ASEAN markets. It's got a long coastline with deep water ports at Paradip, Dhamra and Gopalpur, which make it very easy for any trading activity. Power surplus state with over 17,600 megawatts of power production, contains 11% of India's water resources, and a natural gas pipeline which is coming up, which would connect the 13 most industrial districts of the state and make the power generated through natural gas at a very, very competitive rate. The East Coast Economic Corridor, which is starting from Kanyakumari, is covering the entire length of the state. And as a result, the regions in the vicinity, the investment regions like the one at Dhamra, the PCPIR, the Petroleum Chemical and Petrochemical Investment Region at Paradip, the Kalinganagar Investment Manufacturing Zone, which is now becoming the steel hub of the country, the Info Valley, where the electronics and IT sector is coming up very well, and some more sector-specific clusters, make this entire region a area which would see, is actually already seeing and would see very, very fast economic growth over the next decade or so, and would be one of the most industrial belts in the entire country. The National Waterway number 5 is coming up, which would connect the industrial regions to ports at Dhamra and Paradip, bring down radically the cost of transporting bulk cargo. The natural gas pipeline I just mentioned to you. The fourth advantage is the fact that Odisha is a resource-rich coastal state. So while many other states have the resources, but this is the only state having a coastline as well. It's a leader in the mineral ore availability, whether you talk of chromite, iron ore, bauxite, coal, manganese. So we are a mineral-rich state, that is quite well known. But the fact of value addition which has happened in the recent past is something which many people are not aware. And going forward, the state government has a vision of adding 50% of adding value to 50% of the metal which is right now produced in the state. So you would see in the next few years a great thrust by the state government on creating an enabling ecosystem for the value-added industries to come up in the state. Skilled in Odisha is a brand which is coming up all over the country, across the globe. The state government has established a skill development authority, which is to facilitate the skilling needs of the industries. We are producing almost 200,000 technical manpower every year, a fact which is again not known to many people. And the brand of Skilled in Odisha, which is coming up, would ensure that the skilled manpower, which already I think Tamil Nadu as well is enjoying the skilled manpower that Odisha produces. And gradually this brand would ensure that just by virtue of the fact that a labor is skilled in Odisha, it would bring a premium in the job market compared to the fact that you are skilled elsewhere in the world. The sixth advantage is the cost of doing business, which is very competitive in terms of the various factors of production, whether you talk of the wage rate of skilled labor or the industrial power tariff. So we've just done this comparison with the other states in the country as to how Odisha fares in the cost of doing business. Industrial power tariff, the cost of living, cost of land, and generally I think you would find that cost of doing production in Odisha would be about 20% less than in many of the other industrial states in the country. We've been talking a lot of the ease of doing business. So state government has set up a very revolutionary system called GoSwift, which stands for Government of Odisha, Single Window for Investor Facilitation and Tracking, which meets all the requirements of an industry from the time it conceives of a project till the time it gets the approvals, goes into production and much beyond. So just one portal one has to visit, and all the one's requirements for any interface with the government authorities can get addressed by using this one portal. State government also has put in place policies for other sectors which are the thrust sectors, so as to ensure that the other sectors which require specific attention do not get ignored in the process of putting in place a general industrial policy. So the specific industrial policy addresses the specific needs of that particular industry so as to ensure that the ecosystem for that particular sector is conducive. So this is again something the state government has done in the recent past, a land bank of almost 125,000 acres, which ensures that the ready availability of land is there for the industry. I think some of the industries from Chennai who have moved to Odisha in the recent past will corroborate about the ease of getting land in the state. We have an online portal which is GIS based, which ensures that an initial recce can be done on this portal, giving your specifications in terms of the requirement of land. For example, one can search for 15 acres of land in 10 kilometer radius of a port, or 30 kilometers of land 30 kilometers from the highway. So these searches can happen, which will make it very easy to identify the land parcels which are readily available with the government, and then subsequently once you give your proposal and get the approvals, the process of land allotment can be then expedited. The 10th reason is the capital city Bhubaneswar, which is a great place to live and to do business. You may recall that in the smart city challenge that the government of India ran in 2015, Odisha was the number, Bhubaneswar was the number one in those rankings. The smart city is coming up very well, and the Make in Odisha conclave is one reason for you to visit the state capital to see the number one smart city in the making. The Make in Odisha conclave happening from the 11th to 15th is not just an investment promotion event. It's an event which goes much beyond that. It is an event which where the best minds would meet, would deliberate about the issues facing public service delivery, which would also deliberate on other economic issues that are being faced by the industry and beyond, so that it becomes a great place to meet people, like-minded people, and talk about things which concern all of us. So we would be extremely delighted in case you were to plan your visit to Odisha during that time, and we'll be there to support you in case you were to decide on making Odisha as your next investment destination. We'll be there to handhold you from the beginning till the time you set up your unit. Thank you very much.